And these findings indicate that polytungstate ligands are unlikely to participate in the water oxidation reaction, and therefore they should be effectively inert under catalytic conditions. So these are main points of this research. And now, and finally, I would like to touch our theoretical study of the mechanism of O2 formation and release from not polyoxymetallate compound, but manganese 4 oxygen 4 cubane cluster, which is actually the model of water oxidation of oxygen evolving complex in biological systems. Previous studies performed by Desmukis and Kovakers demonstrated that two of four equivalent oxygen atoms in the core of this cubane can undergo a reduction by the so-called proton-coupled electron transfer reaction, and they can give us two water molecules forming species like this. So this process is readily reversible. So it proceeds this way. First, by absorbing light, this molecule loses one ligand, forming this kind of butterfly structure, which loses O2 molecule, forming so-called open butterfly, which can add ligand back and to form this kind of reduced compound. So it was necessary to elucidate mechanism and controlling factors of the total reaction. So we decided to investigate this compound with smaller ligands. So here we use this ion as a model for a ligand in this compound. Again, studies were performed using Gaussian O3, and we used bis-release planel 2DZ level of theory with additional D functions for the phosphorus. So this kind of approach. It was shown to work well for manganese oxygen compounds. For all species which we studied, we calculated frequencies and transition states were checked to have one imaginary frequency corresponding to the reaction coordinates. Solvent effects were estimated using water as a solvent. And furthermore, gas phase Gibbs-free energetics calculated at this level of theory is discussed, and energies with solvent effects are provided in parentheses. So here is the original model. The model of the original compound with all six ligands. So when it loses one ligand, it forms a reactant intermediate. So what occurs furthermore? These intermediates undergoes direct oxygen bond formation, which proceeds with this quite large energy barrier, about 30 kilocalories per mole. So as we can see, it proceeds through this transition state where bonds with these two manganese are broken, and O2 unit starts to form. And in the intermediate product of this step, we have this kind of mu eta 2 O2 to O2 minus unit. So what we have? These two manganese become reduced by one electron each. So and these bond distances, as we can see, are significantly elongated. And this species transforms into this kind of compound where O2 unit is bound just by one really long bond with each manganese in each manganese of this layer, and is not bound to these two manganese, which are reduced from +4 to +3 state. So we were unable to find the transition state which binds these two, which bridges these two species. So furthermore, through rotation of O2 unit in this transition state, we have opening of the whole butterfly compound, making this molecule with intermediate with a flat part, and O2 unit is now bound to one of the manganese of the top layer and one of the manganese of this second layer. Now it this O2 unit has charge 2-, and it so to say dances between these two manganese. And also what is important, we can see that that reactant and transition states and intermediates have very high spin multiplicities because of many unpaired electrons on manganese centers, of course. So this open species through this transition state transforms into intermediate where O2 is bound just to one manganese atom, and then this compound, this intermediate loses O2 molecule, forming this kind of open butterfly species, which could interact with ligand and we will have just original compound, so to say, without O2 moiety, without O2 unit. So as we can see, the total reaction of O2 dissociation is quite highly exothermic, both in gas phase and with solvent effects taken into account. So this is the potential energy surface for the whole reaction. As we can see, the highest barrier is the is formation of bridged O2 moiety. And the total reaction has this exothermicity, which is not too large, we could say, but still it tells us about feasibility of the whole process. And the whole reaction is four electron oxidation reduction process via manganese centers of the manganese four core of this compound transform from this combination to this combination. So we can see that first two manganese have oxidation state 3 and two manganese have oxidation state 4, but finally in this compound two manganese have oxidation state 2 and two manganese have oxidation state 3. In other words, upon oxygen O2 formation in starting cationic complex, all four manganese centers are reduced by one electron each, and the overall reaction is exothermic by these amounts of energy, so can occur pretty easily. Okay. Thank you very much for your attention.